Hey brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick in the Philippines. I haven't made a video much this week. I thought I'd come on here and make just a quick video. Actually, I've made a video and I haven't loaded it. As I mentioned in the video that I did load, I was minding my own business here, working on the website, Joshua's Ministry for the Orphanage, and I saw where Obama had given his Easter address. And I read what he said, and I made a video entitled, you know, Obama's not the Antichrist. As I've already made three or four videos in the past saying that Obama's not the Antichrist. And then I really got into the politics of the thing, and I made one other video way back that was a little bit political. And, you know, I've studied that stuff before I became a pastor, and I've studied it since as part of the research I did for the book that I wrote. And it's really part of studying, because I've been studying the end times really since back before when I first learned about it when I was a teenager. And then after I stopped being a backslider and came back to the Lord, I've been studying it, you know, basically steadily since 2000. And so part of the end times is, of course, is looking at current events. And all the things involving the, you know, the rise of the Antichrist, the rise of the Mark of the Beast, all those different things. There's different categories that you can look at. And so I follow that stuff for the purpose of the ministry. But I decided that I'm still not sure. I think my video was a little bit too political, even though I wanted it. I wanted it to be. That's what I was talking about. Like I said, I've already made videos saying that Obama is not the Antichrist. It's just so controversial, and not that I care about controversy, it's just so bizarre that the Bible tells us that, you know, we don't know who the Antichrist is. He will be revealed, the son of perdition will be revealed when they make this a covenant with many for a 7-year period of time. And all of that revolves around a peace treaty with Israel to rebuild the temple and divide the land of Israel. This is all throughout the Bible. You know, it's even so bizarre. One time I made a video because the Lord had shown me that the son of perdition would betray the king of Israel. And because of the false prophets on YouTube, they've even got Obama synonymous, which means, you know, it's like another way of saying the same thing. That they made President Obama synonymous with the son of perdition. The people who watch YouTube videos, who are into these watching YouTube videos, they automatically thought that's who I was talking about when they saw the title without watching the video. Several of the people, as what is called on the internet, is a troll. A troll is someone who goes around the internet putting comments just to attack people, and that's their whole agenda of watching videos. And then number two, they don't usually watch the videos that they troll on. They go on there in a category. Say they're an atheist and their agenda is to attack Christianity. They will go on every website they see that's Christianity and then put some smart remark. But in this case, trolls who are Obama haters, or say trolls that don't believe in the rapture, is another example. You know, and I catch a lot of trolls. I've made several videos to catch trolls just to be funny, as the Lord had led me. But the message, as an example, the message was for about Mama Mary. I made a message saying that I have a message from the Virgin Mary for the church. And then there were several trolls who trolled that, saying, you know, the Virgin Mary doesn't give anybody messages. But if they had watched the video, they would see that I had said that in John chapter 2 at the wedding of Cana, there was no more wine. And Mary asked Jesus, her son, to do something about it. And he said, you know, what do I have to do with thee? My time has not yet come. And then she told the servants at the wedding, she said, whatever he says, do it. So the word that I gave from the Virgin Mary to the church is, whatever Jesus says, do it. And I got it from the Bible, not from some revelation or vision of the Virgin Mary. And also, you know, the Lord gave me the wisdom to make that video, but, of course the main focus of that was that, you know, people who are Mary worshipers, Mary, You know, there is a section or a sect or a group within Roman Catholicism particularly who exalt the Virgin Mary as their God and Savior. A percentage of Catholics actually believe that. Not all do, but there's a sect that does. There's orders of nuns and all that who, you know, they're dedicated to the Virgin Mary. And then there are people who are not Catholic, who are New Age people who worship the Our Lady of Guadalupe, Our Lady of Lourdes, and, you know, all of these different ones as a cult group. It's a cult thing to worship the Virgin Mary as a god. So that's why the Lord led me to make the video. And secondly, it's also the lesson for people that, like in the Proverbs, it says, you know, to be slow to speak and quick to listen. And it was also a lesson for those who had trolled on there without listening to my message, who attacked without watching the video, to put in their two cents. So it was a lesson learned. And as the Bible also says, if you rebuke a fool, you will feel his wrath. If you rebuke a wise man, he will take it to heart. So those who were wise people who had done like all of us who make mistakes and troll or whatever, if they're rebuked, then they take it to heart. And they say, yeah, I learned a lesson. I shouldn't be trolling. I shouldn't jump to conclusions. I should listen. But those who you would feel their wrath, then of course they would fit the biblical definition of a fool, according to the Word of God. The Bible tells us that the Bible, in James, it tells us that the Bible is a mirror. That when we look at the Word of God, we're beholding ourselves in a mirror. And then it says, if we're not a doer of the Word, but just a hearer only, then we walk away and we forget what we saw in the mirror. But if we look in the mirror and behold and see steadfast that we need to be changed, that we need to correct ourselves, then we become a doer of the word, not a hearer only. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I'm covering all these topics as the Lord would lead me. I wanted to tell you that we're doing the Vacation Bible School. We've been doing it for 2 or 3 weeks now at the orphanage. We'll be wrapping up, 2 weeks. We'll be wrapping up Saturday. I'll be there. I will be evangelizing the parents. All the parents of the children will come. And I will do an evangelism. We're going to videotape that. I do that every year. I don't think we videotaped it before, but I will make a videotape and post that. Just for FYI for you guys, I'm going to be doing it very simple. This is remote area people. I've done some complicated preaching in rural areas, and then they come up and ask me, something like just the basic. The average person that will be there, it's maybe been to the fifth grade, even though they're, it doesn't matter that they're adults. So, and even though I have a translator, when I first came to the Philippines in 2005 as a preacher, I'd given a word when I preached in a church, and it came from the Spirit of the Lord, and the word was is that because it came from Amos, and it's also in another place in the Bible too, at least 2 or 3 other places, but in particular in Amos. It says that because you worship idols that cannot hear and cannot see and cannot speak, I will make you like them, where you cannot hear, where you have ears but cannot hear, and eyes and cannot see, and a voice but cannot speak, and hear the truth. So that's the word I'd given, and that's really true about the Philippines, because it is so steeped in idol worship. Huge part of the Philippines worships Mary, the Virgin Mary, a huge part worships this Santa Nina, which is a baby Jesus. There's a huge sect of this Black Nazarene group, they call it. All these different sects, and that is their God. Different gods. And even though most of the people that I meet, it's like maybe, I bet 5% of Filipinos don't go to Mass. The Philippines is about 90% Catholic, and I would say about 5% of the people are active. The rest of them are just, my grandma goes to church and, maybe they go once a year or whatever. They've never been to catechism or anything. They don't know anything anyway. They're nothing, really, but just following the traditions. And then they say, the Virgin Mary is the one that's helping our family, if you were to ask them. But because of this idolatry, there is a serious, and lots of countries are like that, but the Philippines, I'm talking about from 7 years of experience, There is a deaf and dumb spirit on people. They cannot comprehend. You could say it in English. You can say it in the Filipino national language, which is what they try to call Filipino Tagalog, the language spoken in, you know, in the Manila area. You can say it in the local language where I'm at, even in the native languages. There are several different native languages in the area where I'm at. You could tap dance, stand on your head, sing it, write it, do it in Morse code, any way you wanted to. John 3:16. And as an example, I had a group of Filipinos in one of the churches I started in the States. The original church that I started, like three different ones, the original group. Some of them were from this island, from, as a matter of fact, just the same place I'm at right now. They're from this place. And these people were nurses, registered nurses. And as a matter of fact, her husband was the regional director of the Filipino version of the FBI. It's called the MBI here. MBI. Whatever they call it. Anyway, after 3 years of church, every Friday night, I had church on Friday night, not as a messianic thing, but because that's when the nurses were off work. That was the time that we could do it. And, you know, that's a whole other topic, but you can worship the Lord any day. It doesn't have to be a specific day. All this stuff, people debating about days. Every day is the day we celebrate the Lord. Every day is Sunday to me, or every day is the Sabbath day, whatever you want to call it. As the Bible tells us, we rest, another rest. There's a different rest for us to enter. It's Hebrews chapter 3 and Hebrews chapter 4. We see that we enter into the rest that's by faith in Christ. Enough said. Made lots of videos on that way back. Our Sabbath rest is in Christ. And grace by faith are we saved in Christ. Hebrews chapter 3 and Hebrews chapter 4. Anyway, after 3.5 years of weekly teaching and preaching and praying over, and the Lord had answered all their prayers, baptism, all this stuff, I knew by the Spirit of the Lord that the majority of the people still didn't get it. And I told them, because I was getting ready to leave and come to the Philippines, I told them, you know, I'm kind of frustrated with you guys, to be honest with you. You know, we're just not making as much progress as we could. We should after 3.5 years. And they said to me, well, we think we're doing great. They, you know, they got mad, and there's like 30 people in the first group. They said, had a simultaneous group I did on Saturday night that I did for 2.5 years. I started 1 year after the first group. And they said to me, why do you say that? What do you say that? I said, well, I can feel it in my spirit. I said, well, let's do a test. Let me ask you a question. Are you saved? If you die, do you know you're going to heaven? Yes. How do you know you're going to heaven? This one particular sister who is from this place, who is an RN, whose husband is a regional director of the Filipino FBI, she said to me, I know I'm going to heaven because I go to church. I go to church every week. I've been water baptized. That's how I know I'm going to heaven. Now, there seems to be a barrier, a spiritual barrier of understanding that by grace are we saved through faith. I taught that every week, basically. I went over the gospel because we always had new people. But yet still, there's a barrier. So when I'm going to be, I said all that because on Saturday when I'll be teaching those guys or speaking to them, I'll keep it short, I'll keep it sweet, and I'm going to keep it as simple as I can. And when I was in the Army, you had an acronym, you know, KISS, keep it simple, stupid, you know. So, you know, that's for the speaker. So when we speak to people, we keep it simple, and in this case. So that's, you know, one reason, even though the Lord led me to start my YouTube channel, and as a matter of fact, gave me a dream and really gave me a warning and a command to start my YouTube channel, to tell people about the end times. The personal benefit for me, brothers and sisters, when I started the YouTube, if you've watched my old videos, you'll see, because I wasn't speaking to any native English speaker for years, and it's I never get to use just some basic English, and I couldn't go beyond John 3:16, even with most of the pastors. As I started saying at the beginning of this video, I've done lots of conferences on end times teaching and stuff, and as an example, you know, just on that same topic, I thank the Lord for YouTube and a lot of mature Christians in English-speaking countries and around the world. Not just English-speaking countries, but obviously you had to speak English to understand my videos. But I've done pastors' conferences with pastors who've been pastors for over 20 years. And when I got, they would ask me questions like, what's the difference between the Jews and Israel? You know, these guys have been pastors more than 20 years. So for those of you guys who have read your Bible, those of you guys who are Christians, who are know you're just done any kind of reading of the Bible, you would know that Jews are a tribe of Israel. But, you know, I just think now that I mentioned that, there's lots of you guys who watch my videos and watch videos on YouTube who never even read the Bible. As a matter of fact, there was a sister messaging me yesterday saying that there are people on YouTube making videos saying they're one of the 144,000, a woman. And then this sister messaged her and said, hey, the 144,000, it says are men, 12,000 men from each of the tribes of Israel, the 12 sons of Israel, his descendants. And then this woman responded, well, you know, I haven't really read my Bible too much. But yet, they're on YouTube making videos. That's what I always make the comment. Why don't they go to the courthouse, tell the judge to be quiet, and then they can take over the courtrooms? Or they could go, you know, after they watched a video about law, watch Law and Order on TV. Or maybe they could do that with the police or with a lawyer. They could go to the courthouse and argue and tell the lawyer to sit down. They could get up and do the argument for lawyers, for a defense team or a prosecutor, because they watched Law and Order. You know, I just wonder why people, you know, or what people are thinking, you know, brothers and sisters. It amazes me. The bizarre thinking of people never ceases to amaze me. But, you know, and then there's lots of viewers who message me. They feel the same way. They just can't understand the bizarro world that people would live in, where they would think without even reading the Bible. You know, they have a form of spirituality. You know, they're like Oprah Winfrey. You know, she has a spirituality. You know, I should start saying that too, just for the sake of Brother Roy McFadden, because he always comments when I make a joke. You know, this is not, I'm not Oprah Winfrey. You know, I'm not a New Ager. You know, this is not Oprah Winfrey, but Patrick Winfrey channel. So not New Age, but the Word of God, biblical-based Christianity, to walk according to the will of God in our lives. As the Bible says in Romans 8:14, those who are led by the Spirit, these are the sons of God. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I just wanted to come on here and just do a little chatting, and I'm probably not going to load the video because I was getting pretty aggressive in it. As the Spirit was leading me, I need to pray about it, because you know, the purpose of my YouTube channel is not to proclaim, you know, and defend Obama. But Obama is only a man. He's only a man. And he is not much loved by the world. I don't even want to get into it, because I know the haters of old President Obama. I'm getting into it. Look, I am a conservative. I, even though I'm pretty dark from being in the sun all the time in the Philippines, I am a white person. I am a Republican. I'm a conservative. The Republican Party is a joke. As a matter of fact, there's lots of stuff I've been hearing and seeing that Speaker Boehner is a big-time party boy. That's his problem. He's a country club Republican. He's a Republican in name only, a rhino, as they call it. Anyway, I am not a Democrat. I am not a liberal. I am not a supporter of any of President Obama's policies. Okay? I would never vote for him. Say that up front. Obama is another puppet on a string, like all the presidents have been. If the presidents are not a puppet on a string, they take them out, like what they did Kennedy. I'm not a supporter of President Kennedy. He was also a liberal, but he tried to do his own will, tried to do his own thing. He tried to dismantle the CIA, print his own money, not get us involved in Vietnam, and they took him out. And that's what they'll do. The rest of them, all of them, been puppets on a string. And they do the will of the man. I mean, that's just how it is. But President Obama is probably less evil than lots of presidents, the warmonger presidents we've had. You know, I mentioned that in my other video. if you go look, when President, I'll just say this, there's tons of things I could say, but when President Bush was on Larry King Live, can go look it up. You go look up Carla Faye Tucker on Wikipedia, and you look under the aftermath section. I was just looking at it after I made my video on Easter Sunday. I couldn't think of her name. Carla Faye Tucker, if you look her up, she was someone who was executed. She became a Christian, and they everyone wanted her execution stayed, but President Bush, who was governor of Texas at the time, did not stay her execution. And he was interviewed by Larry King, and he was even laughing about it, about having killed her, smirked about it, and was thought it was funny about her being executed, a Christian woman. And it's even mentioned in her Wikipedia page under the section Aftermath of this Carla Faye Tucker. And I'm sure there's a video of it from when he was on Larry King talking about it in an interview. President Bush and those guys, I've mentioned this in videos before, they go to Bohemian Grove. They get involved in the cremation of care and all this other stuff. They got us involved like a war in Iraq that's not related to 9/11. The neoconservatives, warmongers and all that. President Bush, President Reagan did zero to stop abortions. Nothing. 9 out of 12 Supreme Court justices were appointed by Republicans. President Bush's appointee flip-flop, flip sides, and voted to that Obamacare was lawful to as a tax on people. President Bush's appointee. That shows you that the powers that be that are higher than any president are really in charge. They wanted Obamacare because they want to destroy small businesses. They want to destroy the middle class. They want to destroy our first-class world medical health care system in the United States. They want to destroy it. They want to do away with small businesses and all that. It's part of Agenda 21. Go look that up. It's a part of destroying America, destroying Christianity, destroying the American middle class, destroying the Constitution, all that. It's just all it is. It's a higher. It's not, as they say, the right and left paradigm. Don't get caught up in the politics of all that. The Republicans are not doing anything to stop abortion. Abortion is a $1 billion a year industry. You know, whatever it is. Who knows how much the value of it is. Just as an example, let's look at illegal aliens. There's a left and right paradigm to look at. Look, the Republicans want to have immigration reform. Why? Because they want to get cheap labor for their rich supporters. I've been teaching about, you know, higher level of understanding things. Let's look at the duality and all that stuff. Let's look at the surface, then the initiate level on up higher to the higher levels. Let's look at illegal immigration. The Republicans want to let the illegal aliens stay because it's cheap labor for the big, rich businessman buddies of theirs. You know, they said that in 1990 or whatever, a butcher made $20 an hour. Now a butcher makes $8 an hour. Why? Because there's tons of illegal immigrants who are being butchers illegally for these companies. Therefore, it's destroyed the pay of the American butchers. Now, that's what big business wants. So the Republicans support that. Democrats think that they're going to get a bunch of voters. They think that it's true. You can go look this up and study it in sociology and all that. First generation immigrants are usually liberal. They vote for liberal. But the second and third generation, if they succeed and become successful, they become conservative. And that's pretty standard how it rolls in all immigration groups of people, Italians, whoever, Irish, whoever you want to talk about, or Chinese, whatever. So in this case, it's mostly Hispanic people, the illegal aliens, because they can walk across the border, as opposed to people from the Philippines or wherever. So the Democrats are looking to get voters so they can keep getting, you know, majority in the Senate and the House. And Republicans are looking for cheap labor for their donors, the big business people. But what does the man want? The man wants us to have a de facto one world global village. The man wants to do away with national borders. The man wants to bring in a one-world government, the Illuminati going to the Antichrist, right? So what do? You know, like they had all that stuff about the North American Union, which they just secretly did. They signed up, you know, under President Bush to push through this North American Union. It was all, you know, you can go watch videos about that. They're supposed to be building this superhighway. I-35 through Texas is supposed to be part of it all the way. The All-Can Highway or whatever, or that's from, you know, Mexico, United States and Canada, North America and all that. But that is just that's already going to be done. I mean, it's already being done. That's what they're doing. Just like in Europe, what European politician? Let's say you were a Swedish congressman or whatever. Why would you ever vote to let all of those radicalized Muslims, not all of them, but lots of them are radicalized Muslims, move from the Middle East to where all the European countries are pushing 20% Muslim, and tons of them are radical Muslims, and there's parts of the big cities, even like they said, even in way up in Scotland, you know, in Edinburgh, Scotland, there's neighborhoods where the police don't want to go because it's radicalized with radical Muslims, and it's like a foreign country there. And the police don't want to go. They're going to let them have Sharia law in all these European countries. Do you think any politician would vote to allow the floodgates of any foreigners from anywhere in the world, especially with a hostile religious group and a hostile culture, to come in that's really there to destroy your civilization, destroy your religious background, destroy your political system, economic system, and everything? Who in the world would do that? Nobody but the devil and his people. You know, even the politicians aren't voting for it. The government's just doing it and ignoring everybody's, the people's will. They're doing that all over the world. Same thing in the United States. That's what they're really doing. They're trying to, you know, you wake up tomorrow morning and every one of your neighbors is from another country. And that's what they want. I mean, and I'm saying this as someone who's lived in the Philippines for 7 years. My wife is from the Philippines. She's a legal immigrant. And then my son is half Filipino, half American. So I'm not saying that from some kind of whatever they call it, whatever's the politically correct word, is it xenophobe? I think it is. Whatever. You know, afraid of foreigners. I don't have anything against foreigners. It's a matter of people integrating into your culture. When you come to the Philippines, you know, you need to integrate. If I move to China, I need to integrate in that. As they say, when in Rome, do as the Romans do. But when you flood all these countries with all these different foreigners, you're fomenting civil war. You're fomenting racism. You're fomenting trouble. And that's what they want. Out of chaos comes a new world order. What's written on the back of the dollar bill that announcing the new world order? That whole phrase comes from the oracle of this Kume Sybil, which is the python spirit in the NIV. It calls it the python spirit that Paul cast out. In the King James, it's, what does it say? Anyway, the woman is a fortune teller. She has a spirit of Apollo in here, of her. Her masters took her and paid money to have her demon-possessed with a spirit that spoke by Apollo. Who is the Antichrist? Really, the spirit of the Antichrist, Apollyon, Apollo from the book of Revelation. And it's called the Python spirit. And the, one of the oracles, an oracle is like, you know, the Bible calls the Old Testament, you know, the Bible is the oracles of God. So an oracle is a word given by inspiration from a supernatural source. So one of the oracles, you've heard of the Oracle of Delphi, that's the most famous. But this is the same god, Apollo, Apollyon, this demigod, this fallen angel, who spoke by this, the Kume Sybil. And this is what they, this is a thing about the return of Apollo. That phrase is taken from an oracle from the Antichrist about his own return, about the return of Apollo. Apollyon, or Apollo, they're synonymous in ancient days. And what it says is out of chaos will rise a new world order. So chaos, brothers and sisters, that's what they're creating, chaos, chaos, chaos. That reminds me, you remember from there, I know there's a new movie that younger people would know about, but so it's not that vague of a reference as I was just thinking it was going to be. But, you know, chaos from Maxwell Smart, from Agent 86, you know, the enemy was chaos. I believe that is from Maxwell Smart, from Get Smart. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you. And this whole thing about people, I've been wanting to try to throw this joke in. I heard somebody say a while back, a long time ago, and I've been wanting to throw it out there. And it's, but you know, it's better when it's spontaneous in my teaching. But here's one for you. You know, all these people calling Obama the Antichrist has got me as frustrated as an albino hitchhiking in a blizzard. I mean, that's how I feel about it. You know, it's just like a useless, hopeless situation. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I already went 30 minutes. God bless. Lots of people are asking me for words, and I've been pushing myself to do it, but I'm not going to keep pushing myself to do it. I'm just going to do it as I have time, as the Lord leads. So I'll be working on it as the Lord leads me. God bless you guys.